All right, getting set to go green for 40 laps here at Charlotte. Mark Kinzer on the left, Jack Conchill on the right, giving you the view. Down the back straightaway, Sammy Swindell still leads out over Jack Conchill. Mark Kinzer goes side by side with Dale Blaney and takes third away from him. Here's that battle for third. That's Dale Blaney up top in the Amoco car on board with Mark Kinzer working the bottom, Brad.
Two Mopars running side by side.
Jack Hotchill now feels the heat as they breathe down his back. Look at this. Boy, he got a little wide there, Tony. Dale had to lift.
Yeah, I don't think anybody really knows exactly where to go. They put a little bit of water on the top to try to knock the dust down, and it's nobody's really sure exactly where the fast line is right now, and some guys probably are chasing the setup right now also.
Yep, and that setup will change, and they'll have to move around to battle it all night long.
That's Mark Kinzer's on board from second place. That's Dale Blaney and Jack Hotchill just behind you. And then Paul McMahon running in fifth. Stevie Smith is sixth. Joey Saldana seventh. Steve Kinzer, Donnie Schatz, Craig Delansky, your top ten. There's your leader.
Yep,
Sammy Swindell out front. There is Joey Saldana's white 17. Steve Kinzer on the bottom. Boy, he clipped up on the inside berm there.
Yeah, they cut little notches at the bottom down there for drainage, just when it rains, to let the water not sit on the bottom of the racetrack, let it go to the infield, and that's what caused the front end of his car to go up.
Fight for seventh is what you were looking at. Now you're with the leader, Sammy Swindell, that blue channel lock number one. He's got traffic to contend with, Brad.
Yep, heavy traffic. He's got about a half a straightaway lead right now, but boy, in this traffic, he gets bottled up at all. It won't take long for those guys. Mark Kinzer, who's running second, to catch him.
And giving up some track position right now to come on strong at the end of this race.
Swindell just smacked the wall. The channel lock number one just hit the wall in turn two.
And Mark
Kinzer lost the lead to Mark Kinzer. So Mark Kinzer is your leader. He's just in front of Sammy. There he is. They go upstairs now. And Mark Kinzer with Donnie Schatz to the inside now goes charging up.
I tell you, this track has fooled a lot of people, Ralph. Jack Hotchill for one, they're just backing up. The track's gotten drier than a lot of them thought. But Carl Kinzer, the master, has a slick setup on this thing, and they're going forward.
He hit Sunday, guys. He's sore limping back to the pits. More importantly, more points slipping away. We're back green.
He was only 5 points ahead of Mark Kinzer before the start of this one. And look at Stevie Kinzer. Wow, picking the whole front end up on that thing. Well, that's all brute strength, too, when you got to wrestle that thing, isn't it, Tony?
But he's done it all night. He knows that bump's there, and he's probably using it to his advantage now. He's figured out that if he can run over that bump, it's getting him a foot lower on the racetrack, and he's able to keep not only the left rear, but maybe even the right rear in some moisture also.
Before we went yellow, I commented that Steve Kinzer wanted a yellow where there were so many lap cars between he and Mark Kinzer. We saw Carl there getting all excited. Carl wanted to see this yellow because it got Mark out of lap traffic, and he knew there were six or eight cars between he and Steve Kinzer.
And with only about 5 laps to go for Mark, he should have clean racetrack for most of it. There's your leader right there, and it's Mark Kinzer, Steve Kinzer, Paul McMahon, Dale Blaney, and Sammy Swindell, your top five, and that's what they call clean air in front of you.
Exactly. Gets the air over those big old wings and stuff, gets him out of that traffic and not that risk of getting in a collision.
Sammy Swindell, who looked so strong at the beginning of this thing, is dropping now. He's in fifth, fighting for fourth with Dale Blaney's Amoco car, and almost gets the nose wing taken off. He's just not having a good handling race car anymore.
No, I don't know what he put on for tire, but that Blaney we heard had the 40 on. The longer the race goes, the more abrasive it gets. It should get better, but Blaney got in a little high there and jumped the cushion.
He bobbled. Sammy's got fourth, taking any way he can get him. Sammy came into this one fifth in points, so that'll help him tremendously. Now he's dealing with Pittman. That's a lap car. The next one he needs to get to is Paul McMahon. I don't think he's going to get there because a white flag is out for Mark Kinzer. The Mopar machine is back and charging to the front of the point standings. The two-time World of Outlaw champion is on his way to contesting for a third. Doug Clark throws the checkered and the yellow because Chesson's up along the wall in turn four. But Mark Kinzer has won again this year. Mark Kinzer's last win was at Terre Haute, our last TV show. And guess what? He's found victory lane again. When the TNN cameras are on, there's that heel clicker we've all come to love out of Carl.